Hello, welcome to lesson 11 of the course Introduction to Rapid Application Development Using SQL Server and ASP.NET Maker. I am Benjamin Fadino. In this lesson, we are going to learn how to create relationship between the account types and accounts table in the MOIC BankDB database. As usual, we will ensure that our service is running, our SQL Server service is running. Yes, the Bukoloa instance is running, so we are good. So I'm going to fire up Management Studio. Yeah, the last time out we connected using Windows authentication. So this time around, let me connect using SQL Server authentication. We have the login ID and the username and the password already entered. So I click connect. Now it is time to create relationship. Between the account types table and the accounts table. But before that, let's expand the databases node. Let's right click on accounts table. Sorry, let's expand the accounts table. Let's see the keys that we've got on it. We have the primary key, and then we have the unique key on the account number column. Let's right click on the accounts table. Let's go to design. Last time out, I forgot to create a unique key on bank verification number because more than one account can have the same bank verification number. Many accounts can have the same bank verification number, so we are not going to create a unique key on that. I'm sorry. Okay, so let's shoot. So back to the lesson objective. This morning, we want to create relationship between the accounts table and the account types table. Let me also open the account types table for you. I right click, I go to design. Now, why we want to create this relationship is we want to be able to identify what type of accounts does a particular account belong to. And the way we are going to do that is through a common column in the two tables, and that common column is account type ID. Now, there are requirements for two columns from two different tables to participate in a relationship. The first requirement is that one of the participating columns must be a primary key or a unique key. And that requirement is being satisfied by account type ID column in account types table. It is a primary key. Now, the second requirement for two columns to participate in a relationship is that they must have the same data type. As we can see, the data type of account type ID column in account types table is int, and the data type of account type ID in accounts table is also int. So this requirement is met. Now there are three ways I know of creating relationships between two tables. But in my opinion, the easiest way is to create a database diagram, is creating relationship through database diagram. So I'm going to go through that route. So I'm going to expand the database diagrams node. Now, immediately I do that, SQL Server asks me, the database does not have one or more of the support objects required to use database diagramming. Do you wish to create them? So I say yes. Then the next thing I'll do is I'll right click and then I'll say new database diagram. So I click on account types table, I click add, then I click on accounts, then I click add. After that, I click close. Earlier on, remember I said that one of the requirements for creating a relationship between two tables is that one of the participating columns must be a primary key or a unique key. And then I said that requirement is met by the account type ID column in account types table. It's a primary key. Now, when you want to create a relationship using database diagrams method, you drag from the primary key side to the other column that is not primary key. So that means we are going to drag from account type ID in account types table because it is primary key. We are going to drop it on the other column, that's the account type ID in accounts, which is not a primary key. So let's do it. So I hold down my mouse, I drag, then I drop on the column selector. And immediately I do that, then some dialogues appears. So I click OK. My relationship has been created. Now, the second column, that's the account type ID column in accounts table, has now become what we call a foreign key because of the relationship that we have just created. Now, in closing this lesson, the last thing we are going to do is to save our database diagram. So I go to File, I click on Save, I go to File, I click on Save Diagram underscore O. So let me call it REL underscore accounts underscore account types. In other words, this is the diagram depicting relationship between accounts and account types table. So I click OK. Now the message appears, the following tables will be saved to your database. Do you want to continue? I say yes. So that is how to create relationships between two tables in a database using the database diagram method. Thank you.